Now, another disorder of a female sexual development that I would like to talk about is Turner syndrome. And I want to talk about it separately because it does not really present with any virilization. It is very unique in its presentation. So that is why it is being discussed separately. Nonetheless, there is disordered development in the course of events that we have discussed so far. So what happens in a Turner syndrome, basically Turner syndrome is an aneuploidy most commonly, right? So Turner syndrome has a karyotype of 45XO, right, in which one of the X is missing. So it is a monosomy X. It is a monosomy X, and this is the most common karyotype in women who have Turner syndrome. Apart from this monosomy X, okay, where the missing X, please remember, is paternally derived. The missing X is paternally derived in 80% of cases, okay? In 80% of the cases of monosomy X, the X that is missing is paternally derived. Since it is paternally derived, Turner syndrome is one aneuploidy. Okay, aneuploidy is an extra chromosome as well as a missing chromosome, but single chromosome, whether extra, whether missing, is called as aneuploidy. So Turner syndrome is an aneuploidy. So monosomy X is an aneuploidy. Similarly, we have trisomy 16, 18, 21, Down syndrome. All of these are aneuploidies. And you know that the risk of Down syndrome, trisomy 21, 16, 18, all these risks increase with increasing age of the mother. Not Turner syndrome. Turner syndrome is one anomaly, okay? Turner syndrome is one aneuploidy whose risk is not increased with maternal age, okay? So that is Turner. So aneuploidy whose risk is not increased with maternal age is Turner's. That is monosomy X. All right, so very, very important point to remember there that apart from monosomy X, that is 45XO, there can be other karyotypes also in a case of Turner syndrome, which are less common. Other less common karyotypes could be mosaic forms. In mosaic, what could be there? There could be some cell lines which are XO and some cell lines which are XX. Or there could be very rare form of mosaic where there could be XO and XY cell lines. All right. So it is important that though the most common karyotype is 45XO, that is monosomy X, that is not the only karyotype in Turner syndrome affected females. There can be other less common karyotypes like mosaics, or these mosaics could also be XOXX or XOXY mosaics could also be there, right? Now, what happens with Turner syndrome is, remember I told you that for the development of ovaries, both the X's are supposed to be present normally. So in these cases, what happens that the ovarian development does not proceed normally because there is absence of one X chromosome and only single is present, right? So what happens is that the gonads become dysgenetic. So the gonads become dysgenetic, all right? They are streak ovaries. They are streak ovaries. They are called as streak ovaries. All right, they do start developing some oocytes and follicles, but almost all have atresia, and at the end of their intrauterine life, the ovaries are nothing but a streak of tissue containing almost no follicles, right? So the gonads are dysgenetic or streak ovaries, right? The other important physical features, very, very important point, Turner's is a spot diagnosis. You have to look at a female and you should be able to say this is Turner syndrome, all right? So very, very importantly, the phenotypic manifestations of Turner syndrome are very important to remember. So look at this figure here. This will help you remember from head to toe the manifestations of Turner syndrome. So on one hand, we can see that this young girl has a short stature. There is short stature, very, very importantly, short stature. Okay. Short stature is because of deficiency of SHOX gene. Okay, because of deficiency of SHOX gene, there is short stature. Okay, the SHOX gene is located on the X chromosome. All right, and one X chromosome is missing here. There is haploinsufficiency. There is haploinsufficiency of this gene that results in short stature in a case of Turner syndrome female. The other important aspect, as we can see here, apart from short stature, is this webbed neck. There is a webbed neck. Okay. And if you were to see posteriorly along with the webbed neck, there is a low posterior hairline. There is a low posterior hairline. Okay. As we can see here, look at this. Gonads are not there, right? They're streak ovaries. So they are not synthesizing estrogen also at the time of puberty. So what will happen to this young girl? She will have absent breast development. As you can see here, the nipples are widely spaced nipples. The widely spaced nipples are why? Because she has a shield-like chest, a wide chest, shield chest. Okay. Then proceeding from head to toe, heart. What is the problem in her heart? In her heart, the problem is these young girls, these adolescent girls with Turner syndrome, apart from having manifestations because of absence of estrogen, that is delayed puberty and its consequences, apart from that, they also have associated renal disorders, associated heart disorders, associated autoimmune disorders. So one of the heart disorders in the heart, please remember, in the heart, there is most commonly bicuspid aortic valve is the most common disorder, more common than coarctation of aorta. All right, then coming to the kidneys, what will happen in the kidneys or the renal anomalies, most commonly